In the book of Revelation, it says, and the four beasts, each of them with six wings about him, and they were full of eyes within, and they rest not day and night, saying, holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, which was and is to come. And when those beasts give glory and honor and thanks to him that sat on the throne, who liveth forever and ever, the 24 elders fall down before him that sat on the throne and worship him that liveth forever and ever, and cast their crowns before the throne, saying, thou art worthy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power, for thou hast created all things, and for thy pleasure they are and were created. We want to bring that same atmosphere into the church this morning. Amen. We want to take the time to say, holy, holy, holy are you, Lord Almighty. And this is a simple song that I know everybody knows. And I ask that as the choir sings, you take the time to worship with us. Amen. Amen. Come on, choir. Say,
I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship and adore you.
I worship and adore you.
I just want to tell you.
Just want to tell you.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
More.
More than you.
Does anybody love him on this morning? Say,
I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship it.
I worship it.
I just want to tell you.
Just want to tell you.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
More than anything.
More than anything.
You got it now. Try to sing it with us. We say, I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship and
I worship and adore.
I just want to tell you.
Just want to tell you.
That Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
More.
More than anything.
We'll sing it one more time. Make sure you got it. Say,
I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship it.
I worship it.
I'm taking this time to tell you.
Just want to tell you.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
More.
More than anything.
I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
Say, I love you, Jesus.
I love you,
it becomes personal.
Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
Let's make it corporate.
Jesus.
We love you, Jesus.
We love
you. Do you love him?
Jesus.
We love you, 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 Jesus.
I need you, Jesus.
I need
you. Do you need him?
Jesus.
I need you, Jesus.
I need
every day, every hour.
Jesus.
I need you, Jesus.
I need you, Jesus.
Say, I need you, Jesus.
I need you.
Why do we need you?
I can't make it without you.
Can't make it without you.
Can't make it without you.
I'm like a ship without a sail.
I can't make it without you.
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 I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship and
I worship and adore.
I just want to tell you.
Just want to tell you.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
More.
More than you.
Say, I love you. love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship and adore. I just want to tell you.
Just want to
right
tell
now, Lord.
You.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
More than anything.
More than anything.
We love you, God. We love you. We love you. Say, I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I need you, Jesus.
I need you, Jesus.
I want you, Jesus.
I want you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I can't make it without you.
Can't make it without you.
I can't make it without you.
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 Say, I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship and adore you.
I worship and adore.
I just want to tell you.
Just want to tell you.
Lord, we love you.
Lord, I love you.
More than anything.
More than anything.
And we finish by saying, I just want to say that I love you more than anything. Come on, singers, say,
I just want to say that I love you more than anything.
More than anything, God. More than my money, more than my house. Say, I just want
to say that I
love you. I'm taking the time to say it, God. But I love you more than anything.
I just want to say that I
love you more.
More than
now take the time to say, Lord, I love you. Take the time. As the angels, as the elders said, holy, holy, holy. Take the time to love on God. Take the time to tell him how much you need him, how much you want him. Tell him that you can't make it without him. This is your time right here. Before we start the service, this is your time to commune with God. This is your time. This is your time. You may not have the chance anymore. Take some time right now to tell him you love him. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord, because you first loved me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. It's time for a call to worship, y'all. And I want to share something with you. You know, there was a people called Israel that God called to do the work that he's calling us to do right now. When they went to the temple, they didn't have any chairs. They didn't have anywhere to sit down. They had to stand up. So at the call to worship, we're going to stand up. If you are able, stand up. And let the Lord know that you love him. Hallelujah. We have a scripture this morning for our worship. Coming from Psalms 115. But you, Israel, put your trust in the Lord. But you, O grove, put your trust in the Lord. Clan of Aaron, trust in God. Trust your helper. Trust your ruler. You who fear God, trust in God. Trust your helper, your ruler. Oh God, remember us and bless us. Bless the families of Israel. Bless the families
of Oak Grove and Aaron. And let God bless all who fear God. Bless the small and the great. Oh God, enlarge your family. Oh, let God enlarge your families. Oh, let God enlarge your families, giving growth to you and growth to your children. May you be blessed by God who made heaven and earth. The heavens of heavens is for God, but he put us in charge of the earth. Dead people can't praise the Lord. Not a word to be heard from those buried in the ground. But we bless God. Oh yes, we bless him now and we bless him always. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Heavenly Father, we come before you as long as we know how. Just to say thank you, Lord. Thank you for allowing us to see one more day. Thank you for pouring out your grace and your mercy, oh God, on those who don't deserve it. Thank you for your understanding, Lord. Thank you for your grace and your mercy. Thank you, Lord. Lord, we pray that your will be done. Touch each and every one that comes up here before you today, oh God, that your will be done. This is our prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
gonna have to come up here and sing when it's our time. I'm gonna join the choir, the men's choir, because these ladies have sung this morning. Thank you. Thank you. It's prayer time. It's prayer time. Heavenly Father, we thank you. We thank you, Lord. We look at the list, oh Heavenly Father, and there's nothing that we can do. So we cry out to you, oh Lord, that your will be done, oh God. Give us a heart and a mind to be a blessing where we can be a blessing, oh God. Give us the desire to love one another as you have loved us, oh God. Let your mercy flow. We so much want to go up, but we need to go out to the one next to us, oh God. Help us how to love the person in front of us, oh God. Help us to understand the person in front of us, oh God. Give us the strength, oh Lord. Give us the strength, oh Heavenly Father, to go through losses in life, go through situations in life. Teach us, oh Heavenly Father, how to forgive like you forgave. Teach us, oh Heavenly Father, to be merciful like you have had mercy. Heavenly Father, we're not there yet. But we know, oh Heavenly Father, if you hold on to our hand, we're gonna make it through, oh God. Lord, we pray for each and every one that's on the prayer list this morning, oh God. We don't know who or what the situation is, but we know you know. You know every situation. You know every name. You know every pain. You know every loss. You know it all, oh God. So we come before you to give us strength. Give us a mind to be obedient to your will and to your way. This is our prayer this morning. Holy Spirit, have thine own way. Holy Spirit, have your way. Have your way. This is our prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
His name is Jesus. Do you know him this morning? Do you know him this morning? Amen. And we want to tell you that there's healing in the name. Healing for your body. Healing for your mind. And healing for your soul. Healing is a precious name. Yeah. And we bless that name. There is a name. There is a name. Has he ever healed your body? If he healed your body, let me see your hand. Okay. If I have one question, I will ask, does anybody know the name?
Does anybody love the name?
It's a precious name. Yeah. And we're going to bless. Bless that name. Oh,
Jesus.
There is a name. A name above every other name. Oh,
Jesus.
There is a name.
There is a name.
And his name is Jesus.
Jesus.
His name is Jesus.
Jesus. Jesus.
His name is Jesus.
Jesus. Jesus.
His name is Jesus.
Jesus. Jesus.
The more I call him,
Jesus,
the better
Jesus,
I feel. Is that true?
Jesus, Jesus.
There is no power in my name.
Jesus, Jesus.
But there is power in the name of Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus.
He was born in a manger, meek and lowly. He was born to save you and I. He was born that we might have a right to the tree of life. Thank you, 42 generations just for you. Then he was hung on the cross just for you. But in 3 days, that same Jesus got up with all power. All power. Dunamis power. In his name. And because of that, we can stay here today and call his name. Jesus. Jesus. Stand with us. Say his name. Jesus. You know what's saying? His name is
Jesus.
His name is Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
His name is Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
His name is Jesus.
Jesus.
Just keep saying it. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus,
Jesus.
At the name of Jesus, every knee has got to bow, and every tongue has got to confess. No other choice. At the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
It's a precious name. Yeah. And we bless his name.
There
is a name.
There is a name.
Now take the time to say his name, Jesus. Jesus, say his name, Jesus. Jesus, say his name, Jesus. Say his name with a loud voice. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. There's healing in his name. There's deliverance in his name. There's power in his name.
His name is Jesus. And we love him. And we love him. And we love him. By no other name than being saved. By no other name would demons tremble and run. But by the name of Jesus. His name. Not my name. There is no power in Brion. There is no power in Michael. There is no power in Angel. But when I call on the name of Jesus, things will happen. When I call on the name of Jesus, things happen. Amen. 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 What's his name?
Jesus.
What's his name?
Jesus.
What's his name?
Jesus.
I like the way that sounds. Jesus. Jesus. We can't say anything else. Jesus. We can cry out. Jesus. 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 That's what he is. This morning, I've been tasked to pinch hit, to try to pinch hit. Now, let me tell you this. I played baseball, and I could never hit a curveball. I could hardly hit a fastball. But I went up to bat anyway. So I'm in the batter's box today. Amen. So my job right now is to welcome everyone. And first and foremost, I think it's appropriate if we recognize the brothers in the house, the daddies in the house, the fathers in the house. So I'm going to ask all the men, all the fathers, those who teleconferenced in as well, and you, us is like, y'all get it now, us is like my pastor used to say, he said, us, that's us.
Amen.
We thank you for and welcome you today, this morning, on this great day. It's a glorious day. Y'all don't believe me? I was out in that 99 degree heat, 101 degree heat this past week. And Lord have mercy, I was out yesterday just thanking God. Thanking God. Exactly what we need. I'm going to shut up now. But before I do that, we'd like to recognize any visitors. If you're visiting with us this morning for the first time, the second time, the third time, the fourth time, fifth time, amen, 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 we thank you, we thank you, we welcome you, we thank you, we thank you, amen, thank you for the couple here, for the young lady here, the couple here as well, thank you for the young lady in the back, amen, you could have gone anywhere else, but you chose Oak Grove Baptist Church, The Grove, The Grove, all caps, The Grove. Amen. We thank you. We love you. This is your home for the day. If you feel like taking your shoes off, do so. You at home. You among company. You're among like-minded people. For the scriptures say all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. So we all in this together. But we thank you. We thank you for coming this way this morning as well. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Good morning, Oak Grove family and friends. We are so glad that you connected with us, The Grove Without Walls, where our pastor is Reverend Dr. Franklin D. Watkins. If you're attending, listening, or watching us for the first time, we would like to extend a warm welcome to you. Whether you are watching us on YouTube, Facebook Live, listening on the teleconference line, or attending in person, we would like to thank you for joining us. We appreciate each one of you. We pray that you will have an awesome worship experience with us today. Now it's time for our announcements. We would like to wish all of our fathers a happy Father's Day. Please stop by the tables as you leave today to receive your blessing. In-person Christian development classes have returned. Youth classes are available for all ages. Parents and guardians, please try to bring your youth here on Sundays by 8:30 a.m. The teachers are excited and ready to get them back engaged. The adult classes are held in person and are still available via teleconference with a new number associated for each adult class. Please refer to the weekly newsletter or announcements for the call-in information. June and July have been designated as Dress Down Sundays. Feel free to dress casual during this time. The Marriage Enrichment Ministry team would like to thank those who attended the ministry fair. We hope you left with a clear understanding that our purpose is to celebrate the love of God through Christian fellowship with like-minded people. We will incorporate your suggestions into our calendar and create some more save-the-date opportunities. Stay tuned and prepare to have some good, clean fun. And remember, even if you are single, we encourage you to attend any event that interests you. Believe us when we say all are invited. Team members are Charles and Linda Dickinson, Jean and Cora Davis, Canon and Minister Carol McFarley, and Harold and Minister Patsy McGill. Today is the last day for the baby bottle campaign for GATE. See Sister Ellie Simmons outside the door in section 1 and 2 to turn in your bottles. The church office will be closed on Monday, June 20th, in observance of the Juneteenth holiday. Men's Bible study will be held tomorrow evening at 7 p.m. The scripture reference is 1 Corinthians 6 chapter 12 to the 20th verse on page 32. Deacon McCallum will be the facilitator. The next midday Bible study will be held on Tuesday, June 21st at noon via teleconference. The topic will be Taming the Tongue. Be careful what you say. And the scripture reference is James chapter 3, verses 1 through 12. There will be an appreciation cookout for the ministries and volunteers to say thank you. Mark your calendars for Saturday, June 25th. From 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. You are welcome to bring your tailgate chairs to fellowship outside, or you can dine in the Joy Fellowship Hall. The Inspirational Choir which is our youth choir, will rehearse on Saturday, June 25th at 1 p.m. Attention all music lovers. The Caldwell Piano Studio represent its first annual student piano recital on Saturday, June 25th at 4 p.m. at Covenant Church, located at 6900 Hickory Ridge Road here in Harrisburg. An awards presentation will be held at the conclusion of the recital, which will further accentuate the talents and abilities of the students after the recital performances. If you plan to attend, face masks are required. We hope to see you there. Today is the last day to turn in the form for graduation Sunday, which will take place on June 26th. Also, Sunday the 26th is Youth Sunday, and the theme is College Day. So wear your favorite college paraphernalia. The hymn choir will meet after service next Sunday, June 26th, immediately following worship service. High school seniors, we still have a few scholarships available. You have until June 30th to apply. So take advantage of the opportunities if you have not already applied. For anyone interested in pursuing your GED, there is a scholarship opportunity for you as well. Call the office or pick up the information from our information center. This ends our announcements. Have a safe, productive, and blessed week.
It's Father's Day, a time to celebrate all the wonderful fathers out there. Not just for being shining examples of how great a dad can be, but also for being wonderful reflections of who God is. Like God, you've provided for us. You've shown us how much you care from the very beginning. With God, you've guided us, helping us navigate through every decision, big or small. You've been present. It sounds so simple, but it's so important. Just knowing you're there when we need you. You've been patient with us, helping us to grow and learn from all the mistakes we make. And like God, you forgive us, offering us grace so those mistakes can never define us. And most of all, you've loved us unconditionally as only someone filled with God's love could. So today, we thank you, dads, for all of this and so much more. Happy Father's Day.
Good morning, Oak Grove family and friends. And again, happy Father's Day to the fathers here in the sanctuary, on Facebook, on YouTube, and teleconference. And we hope God will continue to bless you. And today it's Juneteenth, and so we say happy Juneteenth of Freedom Day. But we know that our freedom came when we accepted Jesus as our Lord and Savior. That's our true Freedom Day. But we will celebrate today what man has said, but we are truly free if we accepted Jesus Christ. If everyone will stand, this is time for our offering.
Give him praise. One more time, one more time. Give him praise, give him praise. Thank you, ladies, for that joyful noise there. Good morning, Oak Grove. Good morning, Oak Grove. Good morning to those here in the sanctuary. Good morning to those on Facebook, on YouTube, and on teleconference. Good morning, good morning, good morning. To all the fathers out there, happy Father's Day. Salute. Go ahead and hit that like button on Facebook there for the fathers there. Amen, amen. And to all, happy Juneteenth. Power to the people. I'm blessed to come before you today to give the pastoral prayer. So let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for all the many blessings that you have bestowed and will bestow upon us. Father, we pray for the man of God who will bring your word today. We pray that his study this week and what you have poured into him will pour out into us, dear Lord. So I ask that you fulfill him as he pours out to us what you have given to him this week. allow that word to dwell in us, that we may carry it outside the walls of this church and go out and do your will. Father, bless us and keep us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Let the church say amen. Let me free myself from the mask so that we, in order, our scripture for today is found in Matthew, the gospel according to Matthew, the 16th chapter. And we'll begin reading at the 13th verse. And I'll be reading from the New Living Translation. And if you like to, if you're able to, if you'll stand with me as we honor God. When you have it, say amen, if you have your Bibles with you. Amen. Matthew, the 16th chapter, starting at the 13th verse. Peter's declaration about Jesus. When Jesus came to the region of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, "Who do people say that the Son of Man is? Who do people say that the Son of Man is?" "Well," they replied, "some say John the Baptist, some say Elijah, and others said Jeremiah or one of the other prophets." Then he asked them, "But who do you say I am? Who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter answered. Always get an answer out of Simon Peter. Simon Peter answered, "You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God." Jesus replied, "You are blessed, Simon, son of John, because my Father in heaven has revealed this to you. You did not learn this from any human being. You are blessed, Simon, son of John, because my Father in heaven has revealed this to you. You did not learn this from any human being." The word of God for the people of God. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. Our speaker for today, our preacher for today, is a man of God. And the man of God gave me some words to say on paper that I left at my seat. But where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. So, exercising that liberty, I'd like to present a few words about our speaker, our preacher for the day. And we pray that Pastor Watkins is getting some rest and being renewed and restored by God, the Father, Jesus, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Evangelist James E. Ferguson is a resident of Charlotte, North Carolina. His church home was Morning Star Baptist Church. I started to say is, Reverend, but no, you're one of us now, brother. We ain't gonna let you go. Minister Ferguson has been in ministry for 27 years. He was a member of the White Plains Deliverance Evangelistic Center. He enrolled in the White Plains Bible Institute and graduated on May 2, 1993, and later served as chaplain for 3 years. On May 4, 1997, he was ordained Evangelist James E. Ferguson by the pastor, Dr. Rays Blake. After preaching a short time in the New York area, he and his wife relocated to Charlotte. They became members of the Ebenezer Baptist Church in 2001. He later entered More Than Conquerors College Bible Seminary of Charlotte. He later joined Morningstar Baptist Church, where he served as an associate minister from 2010 to 2019. He now serves, like I said, as one of the associate ministers for here at Oak Grove, and we're gonna tie him up. We ain't gonna let him go nowhere else. But Reverend Ferguson and his wife of 36 years has 3 children and 5 grandchildren. Reverend Ferguson, I'm gonna ask that you stand, if you will, so the people will know, can put a face with a name. Now, congregation, I'm gonna ask that you point your right hand at Reverend Ferguson and repeat after me and do this motion, because we want to keep him rolling. We want to keep the spirit rolling. Preach the word. Preach the word. Preach the word. Amen. After the next selection, and thank you, Reverend Ferguson, after the next selection, the next voice you hear will be that of God the Father, Jesus the Son, and the Holy Spirit speaking through his manservant, Reverend Evangelist James E. Ferguson. Hear ye him. Amen. Thank you. Are you glad? This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and I will be glad. I have a smile on my face. The world might be going crazy, but I'm still glad. Turn to your neighbor. I know you got a mask on, but turn to your neighbor and just smile at them. Just smile. Just smile. Sometimes the world only sees gloom and doom, but we know Jesus. And because of that, I can smile. I can be glad in my situation. I can be glad in my circumstances. Are you glad this morning? Is he doing great things for you? Is he doing great things for you? And we are glad.
Looking to see if Minister of Music name was on my paperwork, because he sang two songs about Jesus today. He preached about Jesus today. And then the choir came back and said, they're glad. They are glad. Amen. Our Father, which art in heaven. Our Father, which art in heaven. This is Father's Day. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. This is the day of the Lord. Our Father, which art in heaven. Good morning, Oak Grove. I am glad to be here today. I'm just so glad to be in your presence. And I hope that I can do what God has given me to do today. Been through a few little trials and errors. And I was sitting there on the bench and said, well, Lord, I never been to this church to preach before. And it's a little larger than some of the churches I've been in the past couple of years. And there's a lot of people here. And what if they don't like me? What if I can't perform as you want me to? And there's a big choir behind me. And the Lord humbled me. He said, son, it's not about you. It's not about you. The ones that sang so beautifully, I'm glad that they sang good. But no matter how well they sang, it's not about them. No matter how well the piano player played or the drummer drummed, it's not about them. Even no matter how well this illustrious choir sing, it's not about them. You came to hear a word of God, and I came that God might use me, but it's not about us. It's about Jesus. So that's why I am so glad. Let's hope I can get my throat together here. But I'm going to go on and do the best that I can, because it's not about me. It's about the word of God. And I'm glad, because a long time ago I made a vow to the Lord. I made a vow that I would serve him until I die. I am on the battlefield for my Lord. I am on the battlefield for my Lord. But I promise him that I will serve.
Just want to thank God for the pastor to give me this opportunity to come before you today and to serve and to have an opportunity to speak openly about someone that I love dearly. Our scripture today is coming from the book of Matthew, 16th chapter, 13 to the 17th verse. I know that it has already been read, but I am of the occasion of reading for myself. Matthew 16 chapter, starting at the 13th verse and going to the 17th verse for your hearing pleasure. Matthew 16, verse 13. When Jesus came into the coast of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, saying, "Whom do men say the Son of Man am?" And they said, "Some that thou art John the Baptist, some Elijah, and others Jeremiah, or one of the prophets." And he said unto them, "But whom say ye that I am?" And Simon Peter answered and said, "Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God." And Jesus answered and said unto him, "Blessed art thou, Simon Bar-Jonah, for flesh and blood have not revealed it unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven." Let us pray. Open my eyes that I may see glimpses of truth thou hast for me. Open my ears that I may hear voices of truth thou sendest clear. Open my mouth and let me bear gladly the warm truth everywhere. Dear Lord, in the name of Jesus, Father, I come completely humble, completely void of knowledge or wisdom, unless you seed it into me. I thank you for this day, and I ask, Lord, that you would be with me as I continue, dear Lord, to be on that battlefield for my Lord. I know that Satan comes and tries to hinder in every way and any way. But today, Lord, I pray you would give me strength to bear through. This I pray in the name of Jesus, my Lord, my Savior, and my God. Indeed do I pledge, in Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated. The topic that I would like to use today, do you know who Jesus is? As I said, I heard the pastor of Reverend Breon say several times about Jesus. Do you know who Jesus is? I know that we know about him, but do we know him? Sometimes we can have a good friend in life, and they're always at our back, but then sometimes when we really need them, they do a U-turn on us. And we wonder, did we really know them? I didn't think that they would do that to me. Life sometimes gives us some turns. And we didn't know these things were ahead of us. But God is always on our side. The question, do you know who Jesus is? Do you know that Jesus is the one that died for you? Do you know that Jesus is the one that brought you over a bridge? Do you know that Jesus is the one that woke you up this morning, started you on your way? Do you know who Jesus is? Many times we think we know, but do we really know how close Jesus is to us. I would like to say at this time, Happy Father's Day to all the fathers in the house, to all the stepfathers, to all the grandfathers, to all the would-be fathers, and of course, also to those young men who might say, oops, I'm the father. Happy Father's Day. So who is Jesus? For generations and generations, men have struggled with this question. They have struggled with an identification situation of who Jesus was. Many times we, as a child, hear our parents talk about Jesus. They talk about God, and we learn more about God than we do about Jesus. And maybe that's the reason why sometimes we don't know exactly who Jesus is. Now, here in this 16th chapter of Matthew, we find his disciples struggling with the same age-old question. Who is Jesus? Where did he come from? What do he mean in our lives? And what do we have to do? And what did he get his name from? We can always come up with questions, but hardly any answer. As the civilization moves on and on, we run into different situations and problems in our life. Now, I know many of you knew Jesus, and you knew who Jesus, who you thought Jesus was, but we get into a situation where we begin to look for Jesus like when we were young, we looked for love. You know the song, we were looking for love in all the wrong places. Found love on a two-way highway, but somehow we lost it on a one-way street. Who is Jesus? Who is Jesus to us? The King James says, Jesus is the Son of God. The New King James says, Jesus is the Son of God. Then the NSB Bible says that Jesus is the King, is the Son of God. NLT says, Jesus is the Son of God. NIV says, Jesus is the Son of God. The Amplified Bible said and declares that Jesus is the Son of God. So if all of these Bible verses say that Jesus is the Son of God, why do we try to make him something else? Why do we try to get to God before coming through Jesus? The Bible said you cannot come to God unless you come through Jesus. And Jesus said, I stand at the door, and all you have to do is knock, and I will open the door for you. Do anybody here know who Jesus is? Because you see, when you know who Jesus is, then you know who you are in Jesus. God told Moses, I am that I am. When he asked who Jesus was in his deity form as the Son in the Trinity. But do we really know who Jesus is? And as it says in our Sunday school books, at the end of this lesson, I hope you will know a little bit more about who Jesus is. Here in the Gospel of Matthew, it opens up with Jesus still preaching to the church. And he's doing the same thing today, trying to get through to hard heads like us. Because you see, at the scriptures open, he's talking to the Pharisees and the Sadducees, still looking for a sign from heaven. Well, why would we look for a sign and Jesus standing right in front of them? It's kind of like the old saying, you can't see the tree for the forest. Sometimes we're up so close we can't really see what we're confronted with. But Jesus here was standing right in front of them, but they couldn't see him. You know, when we pray and ask Jesus to come and to help and for Jesus to come and heal, and then Jesus do it and we still looking for him. We're asking for things, we're asking for salvation, we're asking for healing. Jesus do it, and we walk away and forget to thank him for it. Do we know who Jesus is? Now here in the scriptures, even his disciples was questionable about Jesus' identity. Sometimes you can look at the forest and you don't even see the trees. Do you know who Jesus is? Now it's interesting that as this book of Matthew opens up in the 13th verse, and it says, when Jesus came into the coast of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples a question. And I want you to note that here is what I call a two-way bilateral question. Because he asked a question, and at the same time, he gives the answer. Wish that I had that on the SATs. But Jesus says, whom do men say that? Whom do men say that? That's the first part of the question. That is a question. But here at the end of it is the answer to the first part. He then says, what? I, the Son of Man. So in asking the question, he also tells them the answer. So the disciples, yet after they've been through so much with Jesus, fed thousands with just a small amount of food, healed people, let the blind to see, the crippled to walk, and yet they're still struggling on who Jesus is. How many of you know who Jesus really is? Been to church every day of our lives, some of us, but still don't know who Jesus is. The Bible says, what hinders you? Is it not enough Bible study? Is there not enough churches in the world? Who and what hinders you? Do you really know who Jesus is? And before you go home today, I hope that you'll be able to answer that question fully and righteously, to know who Jesus really is. The songwriter said, at the name of Jesus, and I think I even heard the brother mention that, every knee shall bow. Go down. Every tongue shall confess. And one day that's going to happen. I don't know about you, but I want to be in that march. I want to be on that battlefield. So one day, I want to walk in Jerusalem just like John. Say hello to the angels up there. I want to go to heaven. And that's just where I'm going. He says in the 15th verse, he said unto them, Whom say ye that I am? Now, isn't that something that sometimes people ask the question, and you come up with all kind of answers? Now, here they've been walking with Jesus for years, and yet when he asked them one question, they begin going into the fishing bowl. At first, he just asked them, whom the people say that I am? First off the bat, they say, well, he must be John the Baptist. That's what they say. They think you're John the Baptist. Well, John was a good man. Well, John was baptized in the River Jordan. Well, John even baptized Jesus. John was a noble man, but John wasn't Jesus. So then they comes up with Elijah. Well, Elijah too was a good man. Elijah ran into 40 prophets of Baal, got scared and ran away, but he was restored. He was a good man, but he wasn't Jesus. And then the third choice was, well, let's get a little deeper. Let's throw Jeremiah. You know Jeremiah. Bible indicates that Jeremiah was known as the weeping prophet. Cried more than he laughed or talked. But I'm sure he had a reason. But Jeremiah was a good man, a prophet of God. But Jeremiah was not Jesus. So now, after they have picked all these different candidates, they say, well, the people also say, Lord, that maybe you're one of the prophets. Now, you know, they're just pulling the straws now. You know how we are. When we run out of questions, we just pick on anything. We just throw an old thing out there. God asked for a sacrificial sacrifice, and we throw out a three-legged goat. We don't care no more because they're bamboozled and they don't know what's going on. But what I like about this scripture is here in the 16th verse, Simon Peter. And I think the brother mentioned something about Peter. He's one of those strong guys, you know. He was one of those guys from the hood. Always had a little something in his pocket. Equalizer. So John stands up here and says, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. And then Jesus said, well, Simon, Bar-Jonah. Now, Bar-Jonah is a word that really means the Jonah part is that you are a son of someone, that your father is this particular person, and they call him Peter by Jonah, but as Christ continued to talk to him, he gave him a reward. And at the end of the verse, you hear him call him the rock. So now he becomes the rock. But Christ's message to him was, you didn't think of this of your own. Your father didn't tell you this. You didn't pick it up at Saturday Night Live. God, my father, the father that is in heaven, he told you this. He reported this to you, to your heart, to your mind. And he said that father now lives in heaven. So who do men say that Jesus is? Who do you say that Jesus is? Do you know who Jesus is? Moses met Jesus after committing murder. Elijah met Jesus fighting the 40 prophets. Nicodemus met Jesus in the middle of the night. Paul met Jesus on the Damascus Road. Do you know who Jesus is? or do you know of him? Now, there's a difference in knowing of someone and knowing that person. Because see, if you know a person, you can rely on that person. But if you just know of that person, you're not sure what he'll do when things get rough, when things get tight, when you need somebody that's right. Do you know who Jesus is? The woman at the well met Jesus, and it changed her whole life. Do you know who Jesus is? If you don't know who Jesus is, I would like to introduce to some and to present to others a man, a friend, a confidant, a redeemer, a healer, a savior, a deliverer, the one who set me free from sin. And his name is Jesus. Isaiah 9:6 prophesied it. He said that unto us a child is born and a son is given. Matthew 1:21 called his name Jesus, born of a virgin. John 3:6 declares that God gave his only son, his begotten son. Not merely a first son, but a begotten son. His name was Jesus. Do you know who Jesus is? Jesus was fully man and fully God. But he never sinned. He gave up deity for humanity to save a sinner like me. Brother Absop left out a degree. S-S-B-G. Sinner saved by grace. And ever since that day, I've been on this battlefield, fighting for my life. Jesus was fully man and fully God. He never received any degrees that other men have now. You know, you can't even get to the name for going through the letters and acronyms. They got an HBC and an MHD and an SEB and a USB. All these letters, by the time you get to the name, you don't know who they are. But Jesus never received any of these degrees. He came from heaven down to save a wretch like me. And in Romans 3:23, all have sinned and came short of the glory of God. But the good news of Jesus is Romans 6:23. The wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. Do you know who Jesus is? What is his name? Jesus. All I know is that he took my sins away. He put me on a path to stay. And if anybody asks you, what's the matter with me? Amen. Just tell them I'm saved, sanctified, Holy Ghost filled, fire baptized, because I got Jesus on my side. Do you know who Jesus is? I am going up to meet him in the sky. Now, I've never been where Jesus died, but I'm going where Jesus lived. And if you don't know this man of God, who is this Jesus? Well, I'm going to let you know right now all about who Jesus is. I remember I was running scared in this city streets of New York, doing everything I thought I was big enough to do, but I didn't know Jesus. But one day, I hit a situation that I couldn't handle, a situation that came out of nowhere. Do you know who Jesus is? Have you ever been in a place where if it wasn't for God, but God, you wouldn't be here today? The thing caught me completely off guard, a situation I would never have dreamed that would have come my way. But there I was. And it had not been for Jesus on my side, I don't know what I would have done. But he came in like a flood, set up a standard, and he saved my soul from a situation. Jesus is the Son of God. He is the living God. He only had a ministry of 3.5 years. Yet, he was responsible for changing the entire world, saving thousands, opening blind eyes, making the lame to walk, giving life to the dead. But in 3.5 years, he changed the course of history for everyone, for generations to come, eternity. Salvation was made available to every one of us. Who is this Jesus? Romans 10:9 said that everybody, because of Jesus, can now be saved. You see, the situation with man was that we were all born sinners. And unless God had sent his Son, we would still be in that situation now. Oh, thank God for Jesus. So who was this man that walked across the pages of history? What was his responsibility to us? And what did mankind have to do to obtain salvation? Jesus, just to believe, to trust, and obey. That's the only thing that we had to do. That was our obligation, and it's still our obligation today. Oh, you don't know who I'm talking about. I'm talking about Jesus. Mary's baby, the Son of God. Jesus, the bright and morning star. Jesus, the bridge over troubled waters. Jesus, the bright and morning star. Jesus, he returns the hearts of the daughters to the mothers and the hearts of the son to the father. Jesus, the love of sons. Jesus is the one. I don't know what you came to do, but I come to do honor to my Lord and Savior. Who is Jesus? He is fully man and fully God. Who is Jesus? He was the beginning and he is the end. Who is Jesus? He was the light and a shining in the darkness. He was the Word, and the Word was with God. John, the Gospel of John, declares that the world was dark, and God sent the light of Jesus into the world. But the world, just like we, refused him. We didn't want no part of this God-made man. But because of Jesus, we all now can see. So who is Jesus? The angels above adore him. Heaven and earth adore him, and the angels bow before him. What's his name? Jesus. He is help in time of trouble. He's a doctor in the sick room, a lawyer in the courtroom, father to the fatherless, mother to the motherless. Do you know who Jesus is? Pilate couldn't kill him. The grave couldn't keep him. The cross couldn't hold him. He took my sins away. His name is Jesus. My God is not dead. My God is alive. And every day I thank him in every way. Because there was a time when I did not have Christ on my side. Who is Jesus? When you're down and out, when you have nowhere else to go, you can learn to call on his name, the name of Jesus. I was a single parent at one time. And I had a son, and he was about 5 years old. And I never will forget that night. I had just picked him up from the babysitter's about 6 p.m. And I took him home, and I did what I thought was cooking dinner. And later on, we sat down, and we had a little prayer. And it wasn't feeling too good. And I said, "Jamal, how you feel?" And he said, "Dad, I'm not feeling that great right now. And I don't know what's coming over, but I feel a little bad." And you know how children, you put them to bed and you hope that a little later on they feel better. Then it came around 2 o'clock that morning. And I heard him coughing in the other room. And as a father, this is Father's Day, I got up out of bed and I went over and I called him by name. And he just mumbled and muffled something. And I started to go back to my room, but then something said, "No, go on into the room. Jesus is the doctor. He comes into your room. He gives you your medicine. He gives you a prescription. That's what Jesus does." But something told me to go into the room. And I went into the room, and when I pulled the cover back, my son had turned pale. So pale that I almost didn't recognize him. And I knew right away something was wrong. And I picked him up and I rushed him into the living room and I looked at him and his eyes was rolling back. And my heart failed. And I called him a name, "Jamal, are you all right? Wake up, this is Daddy, Jamal." And he didn't answer. And I could feel his little body getting warmer and warmer. And I didn't know what to do, but then I remembered my mother's prayers. I remember how my mother used to take me and cry out to the Lord for me when I was sick. I remember when God held me in his hands. I remember and listening to the words of my mother's prayer. And then something came over me and I looked up to the ceiling and I said, "Jesus, Jesus, Jesus." I was out. Didn't know what to do. Calling on Jesus. What's his name? Jesus. And as I continued to call on his name, my son began to get strength. The color came back into his face. His arms became stronger. And I called on Jesus. But if I had not remembered my mother's prayers and calling on Jesus, I don't know what would have happened. Now my son is 240 pounds. Eats up everything I guess he can get his hands on. But I remember the name of Jesus. So if you're here and you don't know who Jesus is, I truly give you an obligation, a responsibility to find out. Because Jesus is the bridge over troubled waters. Jesus is the bright and morning star. Jesus is the doctor in a sick room. Jesus is the lawyer in a courtroom. And no matter what you do or what you say, you cannot get around the name of Jesus. Anytime you need help, just call on his name. Call on him. Jesus, he's the bridge. Jesus, he's the one that can help you. Jesus, be not dismayed. The name of Jesus, as the pastor preached last week, is a powerful name. In the name of Jesus, every knee shall bend, every tongue will confess. And there will come a day when each of us will stand before that Jesus. We will have to give an account. We will have to give an answer. Don't let it be said too late, because when the door shuts, it will be too late. Get to know this man. Get to know this God. He gave up his life when he cried out from the cross. When they hung him wide and they hung him high. And he said, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani. My God, why have you forsaken me? Don't let it come to that for you, that he will forsake you. And he won't if you speak to him first. Sometimes people say that God sent people to hell. No, that's not true. God does not send anyone to hell. But hell is full of people who rejected God. I love the Lord today, and I commit my life to him. Down at the cross where I first met him, where I was first drenched with his blood. And I come here to tell you this morning that Jesus is your Redeemer. Young man, young girl, young boy, whoever you are, the name of Jesus is a powerful name. And as they say, you can hang your hat on that. You can take it to the bank and you won't have to worry about no credits. Jesus is a mighty, mighty name. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, heaven belongs to me. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, heaven belongs to me. Heaven can belong to you too, if you know who Jesus is. And all you have to do is to cry out to him. God loves a contrite heart, a sorrowful heart, that will come and realize that today is the day of salvation. And today is a day, a good day, that you can know Jesus. Amen. Thank you all for sitting so patiently. And thank you for who are praying as I try to struggle around and get out of this situation that Satan is trying to bring upon. But no matter what, if I can't talk or if I can struggle to talk, I'll still call the name of Jesus. And that's one thing that the devil cannot hinder you from. Jesus, my Lord and my God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Again, I want to thank Pastor Watkins for giving me this opportunity. And I pray that at some time I'll be able to come back. I'd love to give my personal testimony and that it will help you in your life and in your journey and in your faith walk with Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Minister Absap will be coming back shortly to give you, to open the doors of the church and to give you an opportunity to come and get to know this man, Jesus, who had walked for 3.5 years with blind eyes, was open, crippled walk, the deaf began to hear because of this man named Jesus. Amen. But at this time, because it is Father's Day, I'd like to give a tribute to all the fathers. So with all the fathers in the house, please stand. Hallelujah. All the fathers in the house. All the fathers in the house. All the grandfathers, stepfathers, those who will be becoming fathers soon, and yes, again, even to the oops fathers. Today, I would like to bestow on you the value of a man, of a husband, and a father. Please repeat after me. On this Father's Day, June 19, 2022, I pledge I will love my wife and family as the Father loves me. I engage to set a standard in my house to be the spiritual leader God ordained all men to be. To maintain fun, fellowship, and relationship with my wife and family. As a man, I will protect my family. As a husband, I will love and cherish my family. And as a father, I will provide for my family. This I pledge on this Father's Day before all these people and to my beloved. Amen. Guys, you can sit down. And now I would like for the ladies, if one of those guys belong to you, you can claim them. But if they belong to you, please stand. All the wives, if you had a man to stand on your behalf, please stand. Those in radio land and on conference call and on view, you can also stand. Now I know you sisters have a habit. When y'all really want to get a point across to us, first you go through the head stuff. We don't want you to do that. But what I want you to do is look into those brown eyes of your man. Or if he's not here, think about him. I didn't say rub him up now, sis. But I want you to look at that man, father, husband, whatever he is to you. And I want you to point your finger at him. And then you say, I heard what you said. All right, ladies, sit down. These fathers have made a pledge, and you have sealed it. So I don't want none of you guys coming at me. We married them for better, for worse. Amen. Thank you so much again, and I make no apologies, but I just love the Lord. And I pray that God will continue to be with you at the end of this Father's Day, and that you would get everything that God has for you. Because God is a mighty God. Amen. Amen. Brother Zapp, you can prepare yourself to come forward.
Let the church say amen. Say it one more time. Now say it one more time to give thanks to Reverend Ferguson for what he's given us, what God has given us. This is a day of declaration. This is a day of declaration. We declared that somebody declared that this is Men's Day. And we give thanks for that. And that's good. Don't misunderstand me. Reverend Ferguson declared who Jesus is. He told us who Jesus is. Peter in the scriptures declared who Jesus is. Paul in Athens at Mars Hill. He said to the Athenians that I declare unto you, I've seen this inscription to the, and it reads to the unknown God. Paul said, it's he that I declare unto you. So there might be somebody out here today, or even on YouTube or Facebook, who's been trying to do it on their own, who's ready to declare that Jesus is my all and all, that I can do nothing without him, but all things are possible with him. There might be somebody that is just tired, can't see their way out. Somebody who's ready to run down this aisle and say, I yield. What must I do to be saved? Let me tell you, I've been there. And I've done that, as they say. So if you'll stand, we'll open the doors. At this time, we're going to open the doors of the church. And if there be someone search of this God who is three in one. Three in one. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. God who loved us so much so that he sacrificed, gave his only Son to die for a wretch like me. About you, gave his only Son. The God who still watches over us. The God who still provides for us and keeps us. He, like Paul said, I declare unto you this day. Is there one here? Is there one here? Is there one here in this section? Is there one here? Now is the appointed time. Now is the appointed time. We thank God. Thank God for his word. Thank you for the preached word. Reverend Ferguson, Evangelist Ferguson. One last chance. One last time. Is there one? Paul said in Athens, you're religious. I see that you're religious. But let me declare this unknown God to you. Is there one? If not, if you'll remain standing, we'll have our closing prayer and benediction. We pray, God, that you have gotten one word of encouragement. We pray that you enjoy, be blessed with the remainder of this our day, men. Father's Day. Amen? Amen. Let us pray. Father, we thank you. If we had 1,000 tongues, we couldn't thank you enough for the blessings that you bestowed upon us this day. You gave us your lifeblood running warmly in our veins, woke us up this morning, and brought us into your house of worship one more time, and we give thanks to you. We thank you for your preached word, oh God. We thank you for the guidance of the Holy Spirit, oh God, in this place. We pray, oh gracious God, that everything that was said and done would bring glory to you. We pray now most of all that your word might fall on fertile ground and there might be one somewhere. The angels in heaven will proclaim and declare joy if there be one who would come and say, I yield, I yield. What must I do to be saved? We thank you for Jesus. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for saving us. Thank you that he sits at your right hand, still pleading and interceding for wretches like me. Thank you, God, that you haven't left us alone. Thank you for the Holy Spirit. And now, God, as we go down from this place, we pray, oh gracious God, that you be with us, lead us, guide us, and direct us. In the name of Jesus, we ask it all. Our benediction is the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance and give you peace. Go in peace. Amen. 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 Thank you.